as males age, almost every male will have BPH.
What happens over time is that the prostate grows and grows and grows. So a lot of men, you know, starting in their late 50s, 60s, and 70s will start to experience symptoms related to this prostate enlargement, because as it's enlarging, it's compressing the urethra, meaning that the urine now is having a hard time passing through the urethra out through the penis. Patients will have urinary frequency, meaning they need to go to the bathroom, you know, sometimes every half an hour or hour. They will have urgency, meaning that they, when they need to go to the bathroom, they really need to rush. Patients will get up at night, and that's probably one of the worst symptoms of this disease, because when your sleep is interrupted, it affects everything. The way I think about it is that you really have like a full spectrum of treatment options, starting with the least invasive, going to the most invasive. So the least invasive, of course, is medical management. On the other end of the spectrum, you have the most invasive, which would be removal, surgical removal of the prostate. Surgical treatment of the prostate is so challenging because there's very little space. And that's where endovascular treatment of the prostate, as we do, really has an advantage, because we don't really need that space around the prostate, right? We're going right into it through the blood vessels.
Prostate artery embolization is something that can be done under just moderate sedation, so a combination of a pain medicine and a relaxation medicine through the IV. It doesn't require a patient to be asleep or under general anesthesia. We access an artery either in the wrist or over the hip with a very small needle and small catheter, leaving just kind of a pinpoint hole in the artery.
We go in through the blood vessels, and then we do what's called digital subtraction angiograms, where we basically map out the vasculature in order to identify the prostatic artery. And there's a lot of variation from one person to another, so it doesn't always come out the same spot, which is why we need to do this imaging. Then we go with our microcatheter into the prostatic artery. Once we're in there, we do another type of imaging, which is called cone beam CT. And with that, we reconstruct three-dimensional images that we can then use to confirm that we're only injecting the prostate. So this step is really useful in making sure that you're not embolizing anything else. We don't want to embolize rectum, penis, bladder, anything else.
We inject what we call microspheres. They're very, very small particles, sort of like grains of sand.
The particles travel with the bloodstream into the prostate and then block the blood flow. And by cutting off a flow of blood to the prostate, we're basically cutting off the prostate from any nutrients that it needs. So by cutting off the bloodstream, what we're doing is we're shrinking down the prostate. But this is not something that happens overnight. This is something that happens over the course of a few weeks.
I see patients 4 weeks after the procedure, and they often will have a pretty significant improvement in their symptoms even at that point. It's incredible to see a patient who comes to you with complaints of getting up 4 or 5 times every single night because of their urinary symptoms related to their enlarged prostate, and I can offer them treatment. And in the weeks and months after the procedure, I am able to see their progress and see that they're finally getting a good night's sleep after many months or years of suffering from urinary symptoms.